Okay, buna dimineața. Good morning, everyone. I'm very, very happy to be back in Romania after some years, a country that I really love. And I'm happy to be here representing Concord Europe, which was mentioned this morning many times, first by Simon Maxwell, then from ECDPM, and then from DEDRE as well. We are a confederation, and your very active member, Romanian member, is FOND. And we represent more than 2,600 NGOs in Europe working in development. I think one of the greatest things of Concord is that we really represent a very diverse group of NGOs and civil society organizations. And one of the nice and very interesting things that we are also doing together with the very technical policy side and, you know, the work on institutions at very different levels, European, global, and national levels. We also try to help our NGOs to translate such a complex messages for European citizens, because many times NGOs, especially the very small ones, are made up by citizens, normal citizens, that perhaps during their spare time they dedicate voluntary work to good things and very interesting topics. So today I'm here to talk about the EYD, the European Year for Development, which is the European Year of this year. And probably you're all familiar with this because you all have a very nice key ring on your neck. This is provided probably by the European Commission, and it's a gadget. Of course, when we talk about development issues, we don't always use gadgets, and sometimes we think some members of Concord thinks that gadgets are a waste of money. But if you want to talk about complex issues with European citizens, sometimes you need to use some instruments. And I was very, very glad to hear from Mr. Barberly, sorry if I didn't pronounce your name correctly. It was mentioning very, very important items like sustainable development, change of mentality, education. I think when we need to talk to citizens and with citizens, we need to really go to basics. We can, SDGs, Millennium Development Goals are very, very interesting and complex issues, but when you go in the street and you try, you know, to talk to the normal citizens, or I don't know, when I try to explain to my grandmother what I'm doing in Brussels, it's very, very difficult for her to understand what I'm doing. And so I really need to translate with very simple words what I'm doing. And I think to get enough support for the new framework and also this SDG watch, you know, to putting pressure on institutions to really be accountable for the new framework, we need citizens. And not everyone will have the time to read and go through the complex document that will come out of New York. Because, I mean, it's impossible, it's just impossible. Also for media, sometimes it's not very interesting. We said sometimes only if you have a lot of people dying in the sea, then you have development issues appearing in newspapers. But we don't want that. And that's why I think with Concord, we had these interesting ideas of supporting the EYD, the European Year for Development 2015. This idea started in 2011. It was proposed at the Concord General Assembly. And I don't know, probably you know that European Years are a nice initiatives of the European Union institutions to really try to explain complex policies to European taxpayers, to citizens. And we have European Years since 1983. I don't know if some of you can mention one other European Year. I don't know if you heard about other, voila, another one perhaps? Exactly. Well, the first European Year was the European Year for Small and Medium Enterprises. And I think, you know, in some cases, hopefully the majority, we had a good results in the sense that European Years helped at different level to really talk to and with citizens about specific issues. And this year, of course, because in 2015 we have pivotal moments. We have the UN General Assembly in September. We will have soon Addis Ababa for the Financing for Development. We have in December the COP21. So we have very important key moments. And then we have, you know, the general public that could understand a bit more what we would like to achieve in these meetings. And so we said, okay, let's cooperate, let's work together with the European institution this year. and let's promote this idea. So we started in 2011, and we arrived last year in 2014 with a strong commitment. We get on board many politicians, you know, people in the European Commission, and we managed to award the 2015 European Year for Development, and that's why then you have all those nice gadgets as well. But we really hope that we don't stay only at the gadget level, because Concord, of course, is participating to this initiative. We really would like to see, let's say, a critical investment in such a year. For us, it's not only putting things on banners and distributing t-shirts or gadgets, it's really asking people to think in a critical way about their reality, and a reality which is not that far from us, because we only live in one planet. So we said, okay, we cannot do this thing only with development people. And we said, let's put together a civil society alliance, which is made out of partners. We, again, like I mentioned, partnership one more time, because we really think that it's important to, you know, work together with different stakeholders and different sectors, of course. And our civil society alliance today, so 6 months after the start of the European years, counts almost 200 NGOs all over Europe, including Fond, because Fond is a Concord member. And as you can see, we really work with other sectors. We try to reach out to environmental NGOs, human rights NGOs, fair trade movements, gender equality, trade unions, because all of those groups, they really have something to do with development. And we think that really together we can make a bigger impact. Sometimes NGOs, they work in silos, as it was mentioned. Sometimes we do exactly the same things, but on different topics. And perhaps putting all our voices together will have a greater impact. Join the family, of course, we are halfway through, but the Civil Society Alliance is absolutely still open. You don't need to pay anything, it's a completely free space, and it's really a platform for discussing, sharing ideas, and perhaps sharing good practices to engage with citizens, with the general public, what we call also partially development education. And that's why some public money on aid is spent in Europe as well, because we need also to kind of use it for development education in our educational systems. And I think this is very important, because whenever we talk about the universality of the new framework, we need to teach those things to our young people and to our students. And only in that way we can reach this change of mentality that was mentioned before. Another, I think, very important thing is that we really are expected to work together with our very bureaucratic, perhaps sometimes, institutions at all levels. So global, we have the UN system. At European level, we have the European system, Commission, Parliament, Committee of the Regions. And then at national level, again, you have your national parliament, then the regionals, local authorities. At all those levels, you really need to find first the people that are very interested, and then see together what you can do to then go and talk to different target groups, because this is very effective. We don't want to be seen, let's say, and Concord, I mean, it's true, we work a lot with the European Commission, but we keep our independence. We have a very, very big number of members. We are very inclusive, and we think we can really be a good voice in this arena also for the future. Talking with citizens means also try to use different languages. And I mean, here you see a couple of pictures. I think this the Help Save the Sandwich is very interesting. WWF is a member of Concord, and they're very good in communication, of course. And in some of their campaigns, they try to use different styles and really try not to use the jargon. A very important point that we discovered working with all those different sectors on the European year was that we needed to find a common space. What is common, talking about development issues in Europe? And we said, perhaps if we talk about, you know, things that are very, very far from our reality, we won't really get a good result. So we really need to think about what is linked to our life, our daily life. And sustainable development, especially sustainable consumption and production, was perhaps one of the good things, because whenever you think about how things are produced and bought and how we consume, this is something that you do every day, talking about food, talking about clothes. When I buy a very cheap T-shirt, do I think about, you know, the supply chain and who is producing it, I don't know, in Bangladesh, how much this person is paid, is this person covered by, you know, working rights or not? And this is also linked to development. And on those things, for example, trade unions, they are very strong. So we really need to work together. We cannot just focus on our thing. World's Best News is also another interesting initiative that started in Denmark. And perhaps, I mean, will really take place. It's now in Ireland and in other countries. We need to talk about good news because, again, like talking about development issues sometimes means talking about negative things. But sometimes when we talk about successes, we also need to sell to people that development is an important thing. And World Best News campaign in Denmark really managed to do that. They have one day per year where they, let's say, ask some companies, private companies, or you know, advertising TVs on railway stations to broadcast interesting news about development and especially positive news. And this could, you know, help in trying to see development with a different lens by the citizens. So I strongly recommend you to go and check the World's Best News campaign, which is part of the European year. Those are the main messages. I've been asked to tell you about the main messages that we are using in the Alliance, of course, together with the Commission. For me, one of the most important and easy one is not about what we give, so how much we give, how much development aid we deliver, but it's about how we live. Am I recycling the Coca-Cola can when I finish my drink? Or am I thinking about which kind of bananas I'm buying or which kind of cafe? And I think, I mean, also those things, fair trade movements, they're doing this a lot in Europe. So we don't really need to think about, you know, Africa or Latin America and going very far, even though in some countries they really face exactly the same problems. Unemployment, growth, I think we really need to put in common the same challenges and see which are the different solutions in different parts of the planet, because the planet is only one. Here, just to mention, I mean, the EYD is divided by thematic months. We are in the month of July, which is about children and youth. This was done to help a little bit to give a thematic focus to this communication initiative, let's say. So people are using each month one theme to promote their messages, and NGOs are very active, that they can do a lot on social medias and Twitter. But I mean, of course, this doesn't really prevent to talk about other issues in different months. A very last point, for us, it's very, very important to be successful in the sense that we don't want the EYD to finish in December without the big results. So we really hope that at least we could engage with some groups in different countries in those critical conversations, really try to explain a little bit more what SDGs is and what the framework is about and what we need to expect from the future. But also we want the European year to be still alive after 2015. And how one of the interesting things that we thought could be interesting, because we also deal with policy in Concord, is to try to put together recommendations, not only from the technical experts and from, you know, the people that are dealing with those things every day, but also from citizens, and then use them to go then to our national institutions, local institutions, and tell them, listen, these are things that are shared by citizens, I think you should implement them as well. And of course, those will be linked to the work of Beyond 2015 and all the campaigns around the SDGs. And I think I can finish here. It was quick. I'm happy to tell you more about the European Year for Development. Those are the months probably you see them better. And I hope that you will also join the Civil Society Alliance through Fond or independently. We're organizing a big event in Milan at the end of October that will talk about sustainable development, sustainable consumption and production and food in Expo Milan, because it's an international event where many, many countries of the world are represented. And I hope many of you can come and participate. So thank you very much again, Mulțumesc, and I hope to receive questions as well in the break. Thank you very much.